Good morning everyone. Now I am going to discuss a problem on solvable for P. I am taking one problem and how we can find out the solvable for P. This is using in the first order but not first degree differential equation. Okay. The solvable for P means the given first order but not first degree equation is it split into factors, rational factors of the first degree of P variable or not. If the possibility of splitting into factors of the first degree P variable, then we can solve the given differential equation by using of the solvable for P. Okay. In the solvable for P, first we can split into rational factors of the first degree of the P variable. Then we can take each and every factor is equal to 0. In the given equation, how many factors are there? Then we are getting the such number of the differential equations of the first order and first degree. Okay. The first order and first degree factor equations, so whatever it may be, those we can solve the by the previous cases of the methods. The equation, the factor of P variables, what are there? Those are equal to 0 means those are reduced to first order, first degree differential equations. In general, the first order, first degree differential equations can be solved by the suitable which method for that particular equations. Then we are getting the solutions. After the getting of those all factor equations, the solutions are can be, we can write the product to form. Why? Because the factors or the product factors in the given first order but not first degree differential equations. In the place of the factor, what we are getting the solution, that we can substitute there. Then the required solution is in X and Y variables with the arbitrary constants. That is the method of the solvable for P. Now I am taking one problem and how we can discuss. Okay. The problem is, solve P square minus 2P cos HX plus 1 equal to 0. Here, P square minus 2P cos hx plus 1 equal to 0, it is a given differential equation which is the first order but not first degree differential equations. This equation, how we can split? We know that, let it be equation 1, we know that cos hx equal to e power x plus e power minus x by 2. Okay, that is substitute in case 1. Therefore, the equation becomes, 1 becomes p square minus 2p into e power x plus e power minus x whole by 2 plus 1 equal to 0. These two get cancelled. Okay, here p square minus px plus minus p e power minus x plus 1 equal to 0. P e power x. Here 1 we can write in these two terms, taking common p minus e power x. Here minus e power x we can take in common, e power minus x we can take in common, or previous before of this we can write in the place of 1, that is p square minus p e power x minus p e power minus x plus e power minus x into e power x is equal to 0. Bases are, then e power minus x plus x means that is e power 0, it is equal to 1, we know that. Okay. From these first two terms taking common p, and in the last two terms taking common e power minus px, then we can easy to split the factors in the first degree of p variable. Here p is taking common means the remaining terms are p minus e power x. in the last two terms, taking common minus e power minus x, then p minus e power x equal to 0. Then the factors are p minus e power x into p minus e power minus x equal to 0. It is the equation 2. Okay, here clearly the given first order but not first degree equation can be split in the factors of the first degree p variable. So the equation 2 can be solved by the method of solvable for p variable. In the solvable for p, we can take the factors equal to 0. P minus e power x equal to 0. P minus e power minus x equal to 0. Okay. We know that p is equal to dy by dx equal to e power x. Separating the variables, dy equal to e power x dx. Integrate on both sides. Integral dy equal to integral e power x dx plus c. 1. Y is equal to e power x, integration is e power x plus c1. Y minus e power x minus c1 equal to 0 is the solution of the first factor. The second factor is dy by dx equal to e power minus x. Again, separating the variables, dy is equal to e power minus x dx. Integrate on both sides. Integral dy equal to integral e power minus x dx plus c2. Here, y is equal to e power minus x by minus 1 plus c2. Then it is y plus e power minus x minus c2 equal to 0. This is the solution of the second factor. For the required solution, we can take the arbitrary constant c1, c2 is equal to c only. Therefore, the general solution of given equation 1 is the product of these two solutions, y minus e power x minus c into y plus e power minus x plus c is equal to, or minus c is equal to 0. This is the solution of the given equation 1. Okay. It is the procedure how we can find out the given equation. And that is the using of solvable for P. If you like this video, please subscribe my channel and share to your friends.